The model that we will consider is a very well-known one, which is finite state machines, and you might have seen them before. At a high level, a state machine is a graph in which nodes represent states of the system, for example, in this case, state 1, state 2, and state 3. Edges represent transitions between states. For instance, in this case, we have one edge from state 1 to state 2, and that means that the system can go from state 1 to state 2. And finally, the labels on the edges represent events and actions. For example, what this label means is that the system goes from state 3 to state 2 when event 5 occurs, and when going from state 3 to state 2, it generates action 4. And there's richer models, richer kind of state machines, but we're just going to stick to these ones, which are enough for our purpose. So how do we build such a finite state machine starting from a specification? The first thing we need to do is to identify the system's boundaries and the input and output to the system. Once we have done that, we can identify within the boundaries of a system the relevant states and transitions. So we split this single state, we refine it into several states. And we also identify how the system can go from one state to another, including which inputs cause which transition and which resulting outputs we can obtain. To better illustrate that, let's look at a concrete example.